Begin our celebration in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and as we gather around the table of the Lord's Word and Body, let us all the more acknowledge the Lord, seeing our defects, much as more, seeing our capacity to be healed, to be back to our own beauty, to our original goodness, to our order, and to our peace. And so for us to be less unworthy to celebrate the mysteries of Christ's love, let us humbly beg for God's pardon and mercy, as we call to mind our sins and shortcomings. I confess
to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do.
Through my most grievous fault.
Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
to God in the highest. Let us pray. O God, who through the grace of adoption chose us to be children of light, grant, we pray, that we may not be wrapped in the darkness of error, but always be seen to stand in the bright light of truth. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Please be seated.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. God did not make death, nor does he rejoice in the destruction of the living, for he fashioned all things that they might have being. And the creatures of the world are wholesome, and there is not a destructive drug among them. nor any domain of the netherworld on earth, for justice is undying. For God formed man to be imperishable, the image of his own nature he made him. But by the envy of the devil, death entered the world, and they who belong to his company experience it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
I will extol you, O Lord, for you drew me clear and did not let my enemies rejoice over me. O Lord, you brought me up from the nether world. You preserved me from among those going down into the pit. Sing praise to the Lord, you, his faithful ones, and give thanks to his holy name. For his anger lasts but a moment, a lifetime his goodwill. At nightfall, weeping enters in, but with the dawn, rejoicing. Hear, O Lord, and have pity on me. O Lord, be my helper. You change my mourning into dancing. O Lord, my God, forever will I give you thanks.
A reading from the second letter of Saint Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, as you excel in every respect, in faith, discourse, knowledge, all earnestness, and in the love we have for you, may you excel in this gracious act also. For you know the gracious act of our Lord Jesus Christ, that though he was rich, for your sake he became poor, so that by his poverty you might become rich. Not that others should have relief while you are burdened, but that as a matter of equality, your abundance at the present time should supply their needs, so that their abundance may also supply your needs, that there may be equality. As it is written, whoever had much did not have more, and whoever had little did not have less. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please all stand.
God,
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
When Jesus had crossed again in the boat to the other side, a large crowd gathered around him, and he stayed close to the sea. One of the synagogue officials named Jairus came forward. Seeing him, he fell at his feet and pleaded earnestly with him, saying, "My daughter is at the point of death. Please come lay your hands on her, that she may get well and live." He went off with him, and a large crowd followed him and pressed upon him. There was a woman afflicted with hemorrhages for 12 years. She had suffered greatly at the hands of many doctors and had spent all that she had. Yet she was not helped, but only grew worse. She had heard about Jesus and came up behind him in the crowd and touched his cloak. She said, "If I but touch his clothes, I shall be cured." Immediately, her flow of blood dried up. She felt in her body that she was healed of her affliction. Jesus, aware at once that power had gone out from him, turned around in the crowd and asked, "Who has touched my clothes?" But his disciples said to Jesus, "You see how the crowd is pressing upon you, and yet you ask, 'Who touched me?'" And he looked around to see who had done it. The woman, realizing that what had happened to her, approached in fear and trembling. She fell down before Jesus and told him the whole truth. He said to her, "Daughter, your faith has saved you. Go in peace and be cured of your affliction." While he was still speaking, people from the synagogue official's house arrived and said, "Your daughter has died. Why trouble the teacher any longer?" Disregarding the message that was reported, Jesus said to the synagogue official, "Do not be afraid, just have faith." He did not allow anyone to accompany him inside except Peter, James, and John, the brother of James. When they arrived at the house of the synagogue official, he caught sight of a commotion, people weeping and wailing loudly. So he went in and said to them, "Why this commotion and weeping? The child is not dead, but asleep." And they ridiculed him. Then he put them all out. He took along the child's father and mother and those who were with him and entered the room where the child was. He took the child by the hand and said to her, "Talitha koum," which means, "Little girl, I say to you, arise." The girl, a child of 12, arose immediately and walked around. At that, they were utterly astounded. He gave strict orders that no one should know this and said that she should be given something to eat. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Maligayang pagdating po sa inyong lahat dito po sa Manila Cathedral as we celebrate the 13th Sunday in Ordinary Time. And we praise the Lord for this opportunity that we are all here celebrating His love and mercy, asking His gift of mercy and love as we face the weekend, as we also express our gratitude and our thanksgiving to God for the many graces the past week we have all received. During my seminary days and hopefully until now, we are not only packed with our daily routine or our daily schedule. Sa seminaryo po, gigising kami ng alas 5:15, magdadasal ng alas 6:30, magsisimba, nasa klase, mag-aaral, maglalaro, matutulog, kakain, and that will be the normal course of the day. But besides those seeming routines of everyday, katulad po ng ilang mga nag-aaral po dito, we get into some light moments as well. We would come up with fellowships, we would come up with programs kung saan pagkakatuwaan po namin ng aming mga sarili. And we would usually gather to places that would accommodate us inside the gym, inside our dining hall, inside our aulas, so on and so forth. And it is a mark and maybe a must. Kapag ka ginamit mo ang isang lugar, you bring it back to order. And that is part of your whole preparation when you celebrate or when you feast. Paghahandaan mo ang iyong bahay, you will celebrate it during that day, and part of it is to bring back to order what seemed to be destroyed, what seemed to be not, what is an order, not in order, and to bring back to order things that was not, that was taken out of place. Bringing back to order was and is our life when we say things not in order or not in its proper place. Dito po sa loob lamang din ng katedral, whenever you go out, our kuyas, our blue boys, we call them, would see to it that your chairs are in order. They see and check that the cathedral, our staff, would be in order whenever that you are here, so that you can be at peace and you can enjoy the beauty of the cathedral. At marahil sa mga bahay naman din po ninyo, and I hope you want everything in order. No? Wala naman po siguro dito na ang bahay ay daig pa ang isang komosyon sa gulo, no? We all want things to be in order. And my dear brothers and sisters, the biggest invitation of our readings for this Sunday would like us to see how God is so earnest. He desires so much things in our life to be back in order. The Book of Wisdom would like to remind us, God did not make death, nor does He rejoice in the destruction of the living, for He fashioned all things that they may have being, and the creatures of the world are wholesome. Hindi naman po siguro nakikita ng Diyos o ayaw ng Diyos na nakikita ang bawat isa sa atin na wasak, na gulo, na wala sa ayos. But even for now, even now at this time that we are all gathered here, it is one thing, it is one desire that God wishes, that everything be back in its proper place, to be back in order. And the gospel that we have heard, a very long one, and yet a very promising story, wishes the same thing, God bringing back to order to humanity. At sa narinig po natin, nakita po natin kung paanong bumabalik muli ang mga tao kay Jesus. And Jesus would also express that people gather, that as people would gather in front of Him, the words that He would teach them would surely make their lives back into order. And the succeeding two stories of healing, the healing of the woman with hemorrhages and the daughter of Jairus, would like us to see that gift and see that reality, how God would like to bring all of us back into order. And my dear brothers and sisters, when God wants our beauty back, kung nais ng Diyos na maibalik muli sa atin yung dating lakas, yung dating sigla, yung dating paghihilom na mayroon tayo, we would like to see that it is not only us wanting it, not only us seeing that our neighbor would need healing, but over and above all, God sees that we all need healing. We all need to be in order. We need to be back in our proper and original beauty and goodness. Ngayon po na marahil naririto po tayo sa pagdiriwang na ito, what seems to be the things that you see in yourself that is not in order? Father, mukhang naguguluhan po ang aking pag-iisip. Father, I cannot really focus much when I pray. Father, I've been bearing this sin from since then on until now. Father, I've been dealing with this kind of sickness that, like this woman with hemorrhages, can even find a fitting result or a fitting remedy or answer. Ilan din po sa atin dito ang hindi bulag sa mga nakikita nilang hindi na maayos sa buhay na ito. Father, hindi na po maayos yung pamilya ko. Father, I'm not anymore in good terms with my friends. My future, my work is not anymore in order. I can't even be productive until now. Gulong-gulo na po ako. But my dear brothers and sisters, when Jesus saw the sickness of this woman, the death of the daughter of Jairus, God, at first and foremost, desired beauty, desired healing, desired goodness, and desired order. At marahil patuloy at walang pagod po tayong naririto sa loob ng Manila Cathedral, and whenever you are face to face with God, we all bring a disordered self. Malungkot, wasak, may pangangailangan, may karamdaman, may pinagdadaanan. And be assured as how the Lord answered this will be the same for all of us. Let God bring you back to order, bring you back to beauty, and bring you back to goodness. My dear brothers and sisters, we rejoice in this kind of love and this kind of God that we all have. He won't disregard our own inorders, our own ugliness, our own pains. But God would like to bring us back to order. God would want to see you beautiful. God would want to see you well. God would want to see you happily living in this world. Because God has seen it for Himself, and God would want it for us to embrace it all the days of our life. God would want us to see beautiful. God would want us to see well. God would want us to see good. Let us offer ourselves, present ourselves, and hear Jesus telling us, do not be afraid, just have faith.
Please all stand.
Let us profess our faith. I believe in God,
the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, He rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen.
God never intended us to die. He created us for life, but we chose death. Christ, our Redeemer, restores us to life, and we come to our Father praying through Him. For every petition we shall say, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Pope and bishops may continue to proclaim the good news of the risen Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people in nations afflicted by poverty may be drawn to the Lord Jesus, who became poor for our sake. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who mourn the death of a child may be consoled by faith in the gentle mercy of our Savior. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our fear of dying may be replaced with trust in God's promise of salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our dear departed may be raised up to eternal joy in heaven. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions and lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass, our prayers for one another, for our brothers and sisters desiring God's healing, God's strength in these times. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
All-powerful God, our lives rest in your hand. Trusting in your provident care, we bring our petitions before you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Pray, beloved brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who graciously accomplish the effects of your mysteries, grant, we pray, that the deeds by which we serve you may be worthy of this sacred gift, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We'll lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Christ our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please all stand.
The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice.
look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope and Jose our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Amen.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please all stand.
Let us pray. May this divine sacrifice we have offered and received fill us with life, O Lord, we pray, so that bound to you in lasting charity, we may bear fruit that lasts forever, through Christ our Lord. On behalf of Monsignor Oli de la Cruz, our rector, we would like again to welcome all of you to the Manila Cathedral, and we would like to express our heartfelt gratitude for your presence, for your support, and for your encouragement as we continue our ministry. Maraming salamat po, maligayang pagdating po sa inyo at pagpalain po kayo ng Diyos. Purihin po natin ang Panginoon. And we also would like to express our gratitude to our Manila Cathedral servants and our staff for helping us out and for being with us as we celebrate our Sunday Eucharist. Maraming maraming salamat po sa inyo. Palakpakan at purihin po natin ang Panginoon. And we would like to thank all of you, most especially those who joined us yesterday during the Pope's Day Mass, together with our Apostolic Nuncio, Archbishop Charles Brown. And as we continue to celebrate, actually this day is the St. Peter's Pence Day. And we still remember the holiness of St. Peter. And we would like to invite all of you the relics of the Holy Fathers, St. John Paul II, St. John the 23rd, and St. Paul the 6th, are available for veneration inside the Blessed Souls Chapel. The chapel is just on your right, malapit po sa image ni St. Peter. You may offer your prayers and ask their intercession that God may continue to put order in our lives, heal us, and strengthen us. Muli po, maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat at palagian po tayong makita po dito sa inyong tahanan sa Intramuros, the Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow down for the blessing. May the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of His Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Amen.